Hi, I'm Mr. Beats. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg, and this video will introduce the concept of consumer utility. We'll use the indifference curve to show how different combinations of goods can produce the same utility. Then we'll use an indifference map to reveal how increasing the combinations of goods can create pathways for achieving higher levels of utility. First, let's talk about utility. What is utility? Well, it's the satisfaction or pleasure we get from consuming a good. Consumers receive more utility by consuming more of a good, at least up to a point. The additional utility from consuming one more unit of a good is referred to as marginal utility. However, each additional unit that we consume tends to not have as much utility as the unit consumed before it. This characteristic of consumption is called diminishing marginal utility. For example, Weston likes to spend time at the gym. Let's assume Weston's total utility increases the more he spends time at the gym. Decreasing marginal utility means that his utility rises at a decreasing rate. So each additional hour spent at the gym has less utility than the previous hour spent at the gym. Think of Weston climbing the hill of utility with each step an additional hour at the gym. Diminishing marginal utility means that he gains less added elevation for every step that he takes. However, spending time at the gym isn't Weston's only source of happiness. He also likes to spend time gaming online with friends. How can we model these preferences between these two goods? Well, each week Weston can trade off between hours spent at the gym and hours spent online. However, when total gym hours are low and online hours are high, the marginal utility lost from one less hour at the gym is greater than the marginal utility gained from one more hour online. To retain the same utility level, one less hour spent at the gym must be replaced by more than one hour online. Indifference curves show the combination of two goods that produce the same utility level. Assume that Weston currently spends 3 hours at the gym each week and 8 hours online each week for a utility level of 100 from both goods. He could maintain that utility level by trading up the curve, sacrificing more hours online for more hours at the gym. Or he could do the opposite, trade down the curve for less hours at the gym and more hours online. Note that the slope of the indifference curve is not constant. To retain the same level of utility, an increasing quantity of one good must be added for the same quantity to decrease in the other good. This creates indifference curves with a convex shape to the origin. The indifference curve reveals that Weston must accrue 4 additional hours of online time just to remain indifferent. Why? Because the number of gym hours each week is small compared to the number of online hours. At this combination of 3 gym hours and 8 online hours, diminishing marginal utility implies that the added utility from one more online hour is smaller than the lost utility from one less gym hour. For Weston to remain indifferent between the two consumption bundles, more than one online hour is needed to make up for the lost gym hour. Each indifference curve indicates the level of a consumer's utility, much like the contour lines of a topographical map show differences in elevation. A contour line reveals all the combinations of spatial dimensions on the map, such as longitude and latitude, that produce the same elevation. Likewise, an indifference curve reveals all the quantity combinations of two goods that produce the same level of consumer utility. A utility map of these indifference curves outlines the potential routes the consumer can take up the utility hill by acquiring greater quantities of goods combinations. Ultimately, this indifference map will be combined with a budget constraint map to reveal how consumers trying to maximize their utility will respond to changes of affordable combinations of goods. If you're still having trouble with indifference curves, come on over to Chegg to see examples that we've already worked through, and you'll see solutions that we provided, or you can speak directly with a Chegg subject matter expert.